I've got a little man that plays the piano in my pocket.
But if you do watch, please like, share, subscribe, tell all your friends. Two comedians face off against each other in a series of jokes. Whoever laughs, drinks a chili shot, or eats an onion. If they randomly chat, no penalty for laughing. Begin.
All right, first joke. My wife told me to quit doing my terrible Arnold Schwarzenegger impression. But don't worry, I'll return.
So bad.
You got a lot more of those jokes, is it?
What, Arnold jokes?
The jokes in general?
A few, you want some?
You wanna go again?
Sure, really? Okay, are you giving up? Why should you never brush your teeth with your left hand?
Because
a toothbrush works better.
I see. Are you left-handed? You've never brushed your teeth with your fingers before?
I have.
How's that?
Unfulfilling.
Why? Which finger do you use?
This one.
That's how you brush your teeth? I really don't think we should say f*** you to the oldest people in Singapore. We should translate it first. Because they don't really speak much English.
Old people should be shut up, man.
I'm grasping at straws.
I tried to get a job on a farm. So the guy asked me, have you ever shoot a horse? And I said, no, but I have told a donkey to f*** off.
How do you shoe a horse?
I haven't done it, so I don't know.
I thought it was a horseshoe joke.
It's sort of a horseshoe joke, but that became a horseshoeing joke.
I think the stereotype of Singaporeans having no sense of humor and being completely emotionless is bullshit.
It's very good. I need a close-up of his face. Yeah, f*** his faces.
Boy, you don't need the lime juice at all.
I recently bought a new toilet brush. But I still think I'll stick to toilet paper. I'll try my finger again.
Right.
My story is very short.
Okay.
Fear not. Okay. Yeah. So this happened to me on set, and I don't know if I handled it in the best way possible, so I'm hoping you can role play with me a bit. So
therapy,
if I can work it through. Okay. So once upon a time, I was on set. I had my script. I was highlighting it in different colors, and I told the director, I'm sorry, I'm very anal about this. And the director looked at me and said, ooh, I love anal. And I didn't know whether this was inappropriate or whether they really loved me being anal or whether, you know, it was... And so I just was quiet.
And then?
I just did this.
And then just, like, never talked about it again?
Yes. But you see, now I don't know. It's been with me for years.
How about I play the director? I say that, and you say what you wanted to say.
I think we should reverse it.
Okay.
So I can get a different perspective. Just so I can...
All right. I'm sorry, I'm a little anal about this.
Ooh. I love anal.
Like the act of it or the personality trait?
Little of both.
So being anal while doing anal. That's your jam.
Perhaps.
So there's like anal squared.
Yes. If you joined in, you'd be anal cubed.
And if I was anal while we're doing anal, with you being anal, there'll be the square of anal squared. So it'd be anal to the power of 4.
Power of 4. I need a calculator.
So how does that make you feel?
I think I've worked through some things today. Feel a little...
So it helped, It helped.
Thank you.
This is the longest high five I've ever done. We should treat old people like we do wine. The older they get, the more we should use them in cooking.
That is very good. And I would normally laugh.
But
I want to hear more of your shit jokes, so I'm going to keep going.
It's really shit. It's just getting shittier.
I want to try a speech joke like you.
Okay, yes,
inspired me to try long jokes.
Yes.
I'm just going to read blankly from this thing with no delivery.
Sure.
A man walks into a bar and says to the bartender, I've got a little man that plays the piano in my pocket.
Yeah. Cheers.
Can you please finish the joke?
Man, he walks into a bar and says to the bartender, I've got a little man that plays the piano in my pocket. The bartender does this, but the man insists, and he says, if I can show him to you, will you give me a free drink? To which the bartender obliges. The man takes him out, and he's only about 10 inches in height, and he plays his little piano. And when the amazed bartender is handing the man his free drink, he asks, if I show you how to do it, will you give me another free drink? So the bartender says, okay. And he says, well, you see, I have the pianist here, and there's a little wizard in my other pocket that grants wishes. So the bartender hands him another free drink, and the man makes his third and final request. He says, if I let you make a wish, will you give me another free drink? So that's three free drinks. The bartender obliges and says, I wish for $1,000. And then 1,000 ducks fill the room. He says, I didn't ask for 1,000 ducks. And the man then responds, well, do you think I asked for a 10-inch pianist?
I think I finally know how painful it is to listen to a long joke. You know how, like, when you have a white T-shirt and there's a stain on it, you're not happy, right? So I think all racism will be solved if people have multicolored semen. See, that's what happens when you don't write a joke beforehand. You may explain it because it starts off as white, then it ends up as a brown or black person. It's easier to feel the same way like you would if you had a white T-shirt that ended up with a brown or black stain. So if you have brown semen, it's brown all the way. If you have black semen, black all the way.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Cows go.
Cows go who?
No, cows go moo. Deanna would have loved that shit.
She would love that shit, man. Singapore has seen a number of... See, now on set, people are hearing it for the second time.
Did it work the first time?
I don't think so.
Why are you doing it again?
Because I'm out of options. The first time. Or would one that worked then?
Yeah, I haven't heard.
2 + 2 = 4. That worked like a charm.
It appears to be working again, but I don't know why.
I also don't know. I spent all this time writing these jokes. The thing that got the most laughs.
It's basic arithmetic.
You just try. Later you just say 2 + 2 = 4. Someone will laugh. Go. But more than one, yeah. Even if I say 2 + 2 = 4, she will laugh.
Wow. Okay, lah.
See? It's perfect. Not bad, like 2 + 2 = 4, that's also the number of shots you've had.
Was it the delivery? What made it work?
It's just one of those things that you had to be there.
Damn it.
See, even there, now it got the second biggest laugh of the day. Both the same joke. Shit joke.
Haresh is the winner.
He's the winner by far. Not even one laugh. But you, when you want IMAX tickets, you son of a bitch. I want a chili party.
You never know.
It's going to be something good again, isn't it?
Chinese chili party?
Yeah. Production company, no budget.